Now come to vocal fremitus. Now what is vocal fremitus? As the name indicates, vocal is related to voice and fremitus is related to the palpation of the vibration produced due to the voice. So what we are supposed to do, we have to check the vocal fremitus in all the 9 areas of the chest. So what are the 9 areas of the chest? We can see this is above the clavicle, this is supraclavicular area. Below clavicle, it is infraclavicular or mammary area. This is at the level of nipple, this is mammary area, and this is inframammary area. At the axilla, this is axillary area, this is infraaxillary area. At the back, this is suprascapular area, interscapular area, and infrascapular area. Above the scapula, suprascapular, in between the scapula is interscapular, and below the scapula, it is infrascapular area. So we have to check for the vocal fremitus in all the areas. So we have to check for the vocal fremitus in all the 9 areas. So what we are supposed to do, we put the ulnar side of our hand over the different areas of the chest and we have to check in the corresponding areas. Not like one side and then another side. We have to check in all the corresponding areas and we have to check symmetrically. And we ask our subject to utter any resonant sound like 1, 2, 3 or 99 or Ram Ram Ram, whatever. So, अभी संतोष जी आपको क्या बोलना है? जब भी मैं हाथ रखूँगी, आपको 99 या 1, 2, 3 बोलना है, है ना? जब भी मैं हाथ रखूँगी. 1, 2, 3. 1,
2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3.
ठीक है.
हाँ, 1, 2, 3.
हाँ, अब ऐसे कर लीजिए.
जी.
फिर से बोलिए.
1, 2, 3.
हाँ, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3.
आगे अब ऐसे हाँ कर लीजिए. ऐसे हाँ कर लीजिए. We have to check in suprascapular area. फिर से बोलिए. 1, 2, 3.
1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3.
So here we could see that whenever I am checking the back areas, I will ask my subject to put hands like this. Why? Why he will put hands like this? Because this will deviate the scapula laterally so that maximum area of the lung field can be exposed. And when we are going to examine for the axillary area, we ask our subject to do hand like this so that that area can be exposed. Okay, so this was about the vocal fremitus. So vocal fremitus was spread equally and symmetrically in all the areas of the lungs. Now, what are the conditions which can increase the vocal fremitus? Obviously, in any lean and thin person, this vocal fremitus will be felt more than the other person. In any obese person, or if there is any pleural pathology like hydrothorax, pneumothorax, this vocal fremitus intensity will be decreased. Why? Because the intervening tissue between the lung and the hand has been increased. So in these cases, the vocal fremitus will be decreased. Suppose if there is any consolidation or collapse of the lung, what will happen to the vocal fremitus? Now because this area of the lung is airless, so sound is transmitted more effectively in this area, so sound will be heard more, it will be more loud. And second thing, because the lung filters the high frequency sounds. So now the normal lung is not there to filter high frequency sound. So that is why high frequency sound will also be heard along with that. So that is why the resultant sound will be little louder. Okay, in case of collapse or consolidation of the lung.